Hello, sorry for the delay. Give me one more minute, then I'll come. So now we're gonna start. I don't know how much I'm gonna play today because, again, I have to go to work tomorrow also. People have to work sometimes. But I have to, again, as I talked about in a few live streams ago, I was talking about some giveaways on this game if you don't have it. And now I actually got the games sent to me by Focus Interactive. It should be a code. So if people have a PS4, I will do a giveaway and I probably think it's gonna be next week, and I'm thinking about doing on one of the maybe that day that is a mountain time trial, one of the time trials days, because it's not a stage where I have to look all the times, so we could do it while the time trial is going on. And now I see I just got a message from a guy called Bedja, something Bedja0805. He actually asked me if I could share play with him, and I said no, and I don't want to add him for my friends list. And because he subscribed to my channel, he believed that that is his right to ask me about that. And then I say I just don't share play. Then he just called me, okay, fuck you. So I don't think it's polite, no matter what. You cannot just believe people are give. I let other people in and do a share play and stuff like that, just because they cannot afford the game. I'm not a fan of that. I think it's respectless to actually just ask people to share play, even because you subscribe on them. I don't care, actually. And he write a lot of messages to me right now. But 2 seconds, I just need to ban him. But his name is message now. So sorry about that, but some guys that don't respect other people. But I just want to say, because I'm tired of people, just because they subscribe on my channel. And it's you, Ivan. I know that, but it's not polite. Just could say fuck you and stuff like that. Just because you cannot afford this game, you actually just lose a just privilege, I would say. And I can actually show you if you give me a minute. He doesn't believe this is coming on the live stream, but it does. But you see in the right top corner, there's some messages popping up, and that is him that's writing. So I'm gonna block him now, and I actually report him. And I know he's probably gonna be. And I report him to PlayStation now as a spam. So if he's not coming on for the moment, and yes, I want to block him, then we see what's happening with him. So if someone watch a guy called Benja0806, and he actually talked bad about me, you understand why. And you can always refer to this, and I will also put a screenshot of it and send to Sony, if they need that. if you think that is wrong, but I actually feel it's sad people are doing stuff like that. I'm here to enjoy myself, and I'm not here. See, I just got a message now for Sony, says thank you for submitting report. So, it actually works. And I just need to see what they have wrote. Again, I'm sorry about that. It should not be something like this. Thank you for submitting a report. A griefing report. We just received your report, we look into it and get back to you as soon as we can. Thank you for helping improve the PlayStation experience. That's right, it's the PlayStation experience. So... okay, back to the game. Yeah, it just one guy who... yeah. He was mad because I didn't want to share play with him. And then I go online, and I don't know if this... that Bandini guy, I don't know. Ivan Bandini, maybe. I don't think it's you. And he just spammed me with messages because I didn't want to share play with him, and he called me fuck you and stuff like that, so. But this stage, I don't know if you saw the stage earlier today. I actually tried to control the peloton, of course, but it was not possible the whole time. And now we should actually just relax in a moment. Yeah, weird. I don't know, understand why people should ruin for other people just because I don't want to share play with him. And I ask him, I say, if you want to, because he sent me a friend request, and I say to him, I don't accept blank friend request. The least you can do is when you send a request to someone, say who you are and or what and why you are. Requesting you, because I don't want people actually. It's like just going to people's home without asking. You understand? Maybe it's my thinking, but I feel it feels like that. It's just it's same with Facebook. Someone just add you as a friend without any actual reason. Stage, but it makes it no less I don't have any guys on my friend list. It won't be surprising to see punches going into the attack in order to distance the sprinters before the final showdown. Okay, let's see. We have two objectives for this stage: is to recover Ulysses, Rhodes, and. Yates, of course, but we tried to go on a breakout with Brambilla, or maybe Lars Using Back is probably a better state for Lars Using Back. And see Kilkowski, Chris Anker Sørensen. We could probably use Chris Anker Sørensen later on, but Lopez is he just needs to stay in his position. Brambilla should protect Ulysses because he needs to be fit for the next few stages. And Luis Leon Sanchez should be top 20 in this stage, so we actually try to do a protection on him. And then we try to go on a breakaway with it.
I'll protect him.
With Lars Using Back. It's probably gonna be a stage where we fast forward a lot because you see there's not much to do and we don't even have a chance to get the polka dot jersey.
Difficulties on the route. However, we could perhaps use the uphill finish to grab a few seconds in the
what do you mean?
Standings.
How to improve? What exactly do you mean? I don't know what you mean by improve, but what do you mean about what should I improve? Is going alone now.
It's looking good. You've got over a minute's lead on the peloton.
We just do a fast forward because there's no reason why we are going alone with him. It's like the breakaway of today with that Fonseca guy. Almost 200 kilometers alone. But this time There's some guys coming up, that's fine. And Banner easily. They could have.
We have to be ready. See now. He's not being protected, and I don't understand why.
Probably because they come there to attack.
Should work with opponents now.
Reason. Yeah, but again, I don't know exactly how I should do it, because it's different. If you don't know cycling, it's hard to actually, you have to know, have a little knowledge about cycling, not because I'm the best player here. There's many people actually maybe better than me. But watching my Tinkoff story, you can see how I protect in Contador and actually try to do attacks when they least forget it, think about it. Like the Contador way, because Contador usually do as many attacks as unexpected. That's why he is so good. But the energy management, it always depends on what level you're playing in, because if you're playing like in champion mode as I do, you should probably, you have to think like two or three levels in front of you, two or three stages in front. It's to say like, okay, there's a mountain, three mountain stages in a row, and you can see there's two flat stages. But just before those mountains, you should not actually work with your mountain riders at all. You should just make sure you're protected as good as possible. And try to sometimes to take control of the peloton, so you actually control the speed on the peloton. Like here, I'm not taking control of the peloton because I don't know need. I don't have riders who actually can do it. The guy who actually can do it is Bombilla and Sanchez, but they don't need to do it because I need. I actually need Luis Sanchez for this stage because he needs on the final climbs. But the stage like this, you can see, it's gonna be tough, and that means if I want to stay ahead on this stage, I can try to do an attack with some of my riders that are actually good in this kind of terrain, but it's gonna be tough. Okay, I don't understand that. I'm not speaking Dutch, I'm Danish.
Green jersey will not change any more today. The leader is ahead by enough points.
You see now we have going to the second stage of, you could say, the second part of this stage that's actually for the climbers and stuff like that. And we should try to make sure that Lars Ysingbakke is actually still in this breakaway as long as he can. Who? Am I a liar? You are. I don't understand. Is it me? Is I'm lying or what do you say? But I don't know if you actually got any advice. But I want to know who Jora says is a liar. Oh, anyway, no one is answering me, so. You see the states. we have a goal set on this, and Luis Leon Sanchez is yeah, I don't understand what now. Just play another. Don't play it. I don't get it. I don't know what you are. You want to refer to that you won without him. Anyway, we have 80 kilometers left, and you see this next uphill section is gonna be tough. It was you, Yoa. It was you that was actually spamming me with comments. Okay. So remember that when you go on your PSN, maybe later, and you have been banned, you know why. I have all the messages, I've saved all the messages. And I put a grief report for you, so, and why should I lie? Only person who says he's lying, and I didn't even know it was you. So you actually just admit it was you that did it. If you can just say nothing. Then I hadn't have a clue it was you, but you actually just say it was you. So that's funny. Anyway, I'm doing a giveaway. I'm thinking about doing the time trial. 2 seconds. I'm doing a giveaway today, doing a time trial, and I'm probably gonna do it on my Twitch channel. If you can play online, you should probably know it. If you have the game. That's fine, Daniel. It's not my you can do it via SharePlay. If you SharePlay, you can do a cooperation game. Anyway, we are focused now on this, so if I'm not actually answer you, it's not because I don't want to. I just need to focus on this moment. See, we're gonna be there. We should try to take control of the next download section.
Okay, we'll relay.
Ask me next week. Right now, you cannot say it. It's too early to say who's gonna win. To see after the elves, but I hope Contador is gonna win. I think Chris Anker Sørensen is gonna win Tour de France. You don't expect him. He's in best form. Chris Anker Sørensen is gonna win this. He's gonna win Tour de France. No one can stop him. Yeah, that's why I don't want to say anything before we reach the next week. We can see Saturday and Sunday. Ask me Monday. Then we can see, because we cannot know how bad shape Contador is, because he hasn't told to press yet. Anyway, we put a pressure on. You see Brambilla and Lopez are away. Try to go up now. When you know the injury Contador has, he hasn't spoke to the press about it because he don't want to let the other guys know. But you see today also, you actually see Froome was again in front in the last group.
He's the best place.
But again, wait after fifth stage. On Thursday we can actually see, at Wednesday we can actually see, because that's a tough stage. It should give some problems if he's not fit. If he's injured too much, he should have problems on Thursday.
His teammates are leading the chase at the head of the peloton. His intentions seem clear. Win in a sprint.
So tomorrow he just recover again. And it will be real sad. But again, we cannot say anything. We don't know how much... We are seeing riders going drive the whole tour with a broken hand. Wellgren, example.
The race is entering a new phase with a steeper profile, offering no breathing space, a terrain conducive to
attacks. Okay, now is the first time we can probably do an attack here, and maybe we can actually go all the way with Lars using back, because he's actually good in these kind of terrains. You never know Contador. If Contador recover completely before he reach the Pyrenees, you will probably see him going on some crazy breakaway. And then he use Mike, and Kreuziger is still in good position. He cannot win Kreuziger, but he's still a threat as long as he's so close. The green jersey, Sagan or Greipel. Cavendish is not going to win that. I don't even think Cavendish is going to go to Paris, because he has to be ready for the Olympic Games. He has to win the track team with Brad Wiggins.
Watch out for him. He's the best puncher in the breakaway.
I actually think this could maybe go all the way. I see they're pushing too hard now. It's not good. We need to take control. But I actually think if I'm lucky, I could maybe go all the way with Lars using back. Just about how I recover.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
I'm not surprised. No, I was actually thinking of Cavendish, because he has to be in form. You remember, he has to do a track Olympic Games. He has to be in good form. He has to be a good sprinter, because they have to do Omium. We have the Olympic Denmark has the Olympic champion in Omium, and Cavendish is riding against him. Actually, they are riding together in 1-on-1 in the first race, and that's gonna be tough. And then he do a 4 kilometers track team with Brad Wiggins. So he has to be in form. He has to be in best shape ever since 2008. We don't know Contador's form. Still, remember, he has been crashing 2 times. You don't know what his form actually is. And that's simple. If he's not in fit form right now, Cavendish, he cannot win the Olympic Games with Brad Wiggins. Simple as that. There's a reason why England has the best track team.
His teammates are leading the chase at the head of the
pack. I see Albasini wants something in this stage, because this stage is for Albasini. But we need to make sure we have to recover him. Lopez's form is good. He should not work anymore. Someone asked about the tactic. When you have a rider, you cannot use anymore. Don't overextend him if he cannot do anything at all. Not dislike. It's not because I dislike Froome, but it's the way he actually drive. He's more a computer man. Yeah, Bohany, yeah. Mm-hmm. Then he has to drive fast. He's like 3 stages behind. I'm from Denmark. See now, we still got 4 minutes to the peloton. It could actually go all the way still. We should just try to get more speed on, but but it doesn't look like the other guys was at work. And Bernard Eisel is actually a good guy to have in front of this. Vichong also, but I don't think it's gonna happen because even we got our winner in our back. We can probably not hold him behind because it's still a tough finish we have here.
At the front, you're the best placed for the green jersey.
Yeah, Lopez should just fuck off. His job is done. Oh, we should not stick to wheels in front. Just be there. Yes, exactly. And Michael Laudrup and Peter Schmeichel and Christian Eriksen and Peter Kasper Schmeichel and Brian Laudrup and Prem Melkær and... And now they actually put the more pressure on. It's good. Border, something. There's a rumor that Mike and Sagan is going to go to the same team. But you can say Mike hasn't been in good training with Contador, so it's now time for him. Yeah, but we never know. He also said he will join Lampre, but also Bjarne Riis have actually a plan with Contador. Contador has, as you know, Contador has a continental team, and maybe Brian Riis is gonna control that team, and then the trying the pro continental. But because Contador is so big rank, he will probably be invited for the big big.
You're the best placed in the breakaway for the mountain classification.
And it depends. Bora has a good sprinter team, and they also need someone in the mountains. You have isn't that Albacina or something? I don't know. I don't know anything about France guys. So I think it's stupid. It's not his fault. It's just people are just retarded. But it's not good for Katsinga. I don't know. He has good riders, but the problem is he don't have enough good riders. He should have a complete mountain team in front of him, like Froome has. If he got that, he wouldn't be in that situation he is now. He had you can see a guy who doesn't have it. He actually doing good. He won the Vuelta, he won the Giro, even without help. In Vuelta he didn't have any help. In the Giro he actually had Kreuziger, but he was not even in form at that time. Okay, I don't know who are you talking to, or writing to me, or what.
He's in trouble. It's not sure that he'll be there for the sprint.
Come on, come on, come on.
All the Danish riders are my favorites. I don't care who. It's just cool to see so many Danish riders again. I'm actually gonna think Matty Barcel is gonna win one stage or something.
You are 2 kilometers from the top. Watch out for him. He's the best puncher in the free.
What about it? As I say before, it suck. You cannot there's nothing to say about it. He's a fighter. You come back. The only problem is it doesn't help.
They're riding hard behind.
It doesn't help Christoph. Because he's not good enough in time trials. This Tour de France this year is not suitable for a rider like Micah. But if it was without time trial, he could probably be a future winner of the Tour de France. This is the last push for me. I actually believe this could go all the way if I'm lucky. I just need to save my energy now.
A teammate has just been dropped. You can't count on him any longer. The peloton is riding hard. Stay well placed.
Ah. Actually say the mountain time trial and then this, I think the state's 19-20. If I can just get to this next uphill without problems, we could actually go all the way. There'll probably come some attack. We need to recover in this downhill section.
The riders up front still have something left. They're upping the pace to try to hold out till the end.
Rucosa was just lucky that he won the world champion. I actually think Sagan is the only one who actually could ride good after he won the world champion. Kwiatkowski sucked when he won it. Cavendish sucked when he won it in Denmark.
With less than 2 minutes lead of the peloton, nothing is yet decided for the head of the race. There's still everything to play for as regards a stage win.
Okay, now we have to change tactic. We cannot win this with Lars using back. We should just continue this effort.
Please.
No, he did not suck, but usually there's many guys that suck. Where you think, oh, how the fuck could he be world champion? But again, it's Cat Evans did not even, when he won world championship, he was not even good. The top is close enough to the finish to attempt a decisive attack. Be careful, though, to keep something reserved in order to maintain the pace onto the final ascent.
The first riders are 2 kilometers from the climb.
Not good enough.
Ten kilometers from the finish for the head of the race. They can believe it's possible if they still have something in the tank for the final short climb.
Panzerwagen. And now the downhill section.
The gap is decreasing, guys. The peloton should be there for the stage win.
And the Panzerwagen put the pace on. Panzerwagen, just stay behind Panzerwagen. Counterattack. There's Contador.
5 kilometers for the breakaway. With a small climb, a stage victory is going to be complicated.
Oh, it's going to be tough, tough.
The last 2 kilometers are uphill. To blow up right now could be very expensive, be it for the stage or the overall.
Gonna die.
1 kilometer. Give it all you've got.
Come on, Roach. Just attack.
Okay, we follow attack.
Alpecin is gonna win the stage. Was not bad, bad finish. It's a good finish. was fine. Yes, it did. Same did Slender. You can call the Sky as the Real Madrid team in cycling. They buy every good riders. So again, recovering. It's fine recovery, but it's not the best recovery we need. So see, there's two more stages. This stage is also a tough stage. Again, it's a stage we cannot do anything of. Actually, the stages we need to make sure we are getting the position we need is this stage and then these four stages. Yeah, you're right. I would say Kwiatkowski is probably because they don't want some competition, but I think they want something for the classics. This stage is
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The arrival in Mans should offer us a great show. A 3 kilometer ramp at over 10%. There's no doubt that only the most explosive riders can play a leading role.
Again, we should just make sure we're protecting some guys here. Maybe to try to take control of the peloton. And we do a fast forward. See what is the status. He's alone in front. He should probably have Lars Bak in front of with him. And then Brambilla should protect.
Okay, we'll gently relay.
What is you? Nobis. Protect Yates. And then Sanson protect Roach. I would probably live stream tomorrow, I think. I'm not sure about tomorrow, but maybe tomorrow night. See, Tinkoff are in front because they have to protect Contador. They're doing anything just to get, make sure he's gonna pull this yellow jersey. Now we have to make sure we are in the right position before we reach this climb, because you see this climb is going to be tough. And we still have control of the peloton at this point. And let's see, these two guys, they don't need to work. They have done their job for today. They should just stay behind now. And now it's time for Brambilla and Lopez and Chris Anka to set the pace.
Okay, we finished quietly.
We're gonna change again to Yates. He can probably check this climb. Then we have Kielkowski. Oh, he should not. These guys. Sorry about that. I was just messing around with this. Him and him. Just not resist. And the rest should go full throttle. 80%. And then Ulysses should protect.
Okay,
Rhodes.
We finished quietly.
Because as you see, Rose is not in good shape as he's supposed to.
Okay, we'll relay.
The race will soon enter its decisive phase. Dumoulin, Nimitz, and some other teams, and Igor Anton does a breakaway. Igor Anton was actually, remember that like 5 years ago, he was 6 years ago, he was actually about to win the Vuelta a España when he crashed out. He never recovered from that. He will never be the same kind of helper. He was riding for Euskaltel at that time. Same with Mika Nevi and some of Sanchez. One great basket riders. Now we reach the uphill. Just hope they have enough energy. And Lars using bark, why is he still there? Don't persist. Okay, that's incredible, they don't understand that. Now he's gonna climb, and there will come some attacks here from all the ferrets. See, the first one is coming.
The peloton is riding hard. Stay well placed.
Should try to go and break over 90%. It's gonna help. Maybe I don't. Maybe they're not tough enough to actually take control of this peloton. Alright, doesn't look like that. It looks like a Quickstep have some plans here. We just not see what it is. But it's something that costs a lot of energy. There's Sanchez. No, I don't like Movistar. And why are you riding with big letters?
There will be 5, 3, 2, and 1 points to be won for the polka dot jersey at the top of the Côte de Sauveterre.
Watch my video earlier or yesterday, you would hear my answer for that. And Chris Anders Sørensen, why is it? He doesn't have any energy level.
Okay, I'll take it easy to the finish.
And how's Ulicio? Yates is still there. Legion, Kilikowski should put some green gel. Roach, blue gel. We need to get up here with Yates.
He's being left behind. It's good news for the overall standings. Sprint in 2 kilometers for the breakaway group.
Who's that? That's TJ Van Garden. Jaron Thomas. Frank Slick. Amazing driver in his younger days, but he was never that good as Frank Slick. As Andy Slick.
The riders up front still have something left. They're upping the pace to try to hold out till the end.
Kilikowski is still trying to... He's just, wait for me.
Okay, I'll wait for you.
As long as we still got those two guys in front here, that's fine.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
Aru. What the f... Ay, damn it.
He asks his guys to maintain the tempo. Watch him. He must feel able to win the stage.
Kilikowski to protect Yates, of course, now.
Okay, I'm coming to protect you.
As long as we still got the two guys in front, it's fine. Maybe we can get back on the next downhill section. Kreuziger, oh, amazing. Just looks like Tienkopf has used all the guys.
Gap is growing. Don't worry. They're not well placed in the overall standings.
Doesn't look like we can get back for now. At least we should try. Piekowski, following Jaron Thomas down. Auto. Just use this as a recovering.
Another 20 kilometers in the saddle and two climbs on the program. The final will be breathless.
Pinot is attacking with his group behind. Yeah, it's gonna be job to work for him. And Yates there. Contador's losses always help us now, but they're coming back now. And then they probably to push it.
The penultimate climb of the day. The top is less than 10 kilometers from the finish, but it's a brave man who would attack here while the Côte de la Croix-Neuve remains, with its 3 kilometers at more than 10%.
Sorry about that, I just need to ends or something. Come on, buddy. Probably attack now. Or maybe Pinot. Nibali can also attack. Well, I would guess it would be foolish to attack now for some of the...
Watch out! There's an attack at the head of the peloton. Still 10 kilometers to gain the upper hand and win the stage.
Good attack by him. I must say that. Gonna win this, I think. We should just make sure we not use too much energy, so we recover good for the next stage. Froome is attacking down the downhill. Yeah, all attacking Contador.
Runners are at the foot of the final difficulty. Watch out, the finish is not at the top of the climb, but 2 kilometers further on.
Oh, Frans Lecke is coming back, that's amazing.
Frontman will soon be at the top. It looks like he's managed to gain the upper hand.
Looks like Dumoulin's gonna win this.
He mustn't seize up in the final kilometers. He's trying to get out of the peloton. Watch out! Watch out, he's going on the attack. It's all flat now for the man at the front. He rides towards victory. Congratulations to him.
Good, not bad. That was not a bad stage. Not bad at all. So, Contador still got the lead. But it looks like those three guys who actually go for this. We should just survive before we actually reach the next week stage. She's still recovering quite good still, because I protect them as much as I can so they're not use all the energy, but this stage is a stage where I should not work at all, because it's so flat as it is. I take 5 minute break. Be right back. Hello again. I actually think I'm gonna stop for today, because again I have to go to work tomorrow. So thank you for watching.